For each sequence given below, find a closed formula for a sub n, the nth term of the sequence. Assume the first term is a sub 0 by relating it to another sequence for which you already know the formula. And I've listed some of the common sequences below, as well as the corresponding closed formulas. One thing you need to be careful about here is for many of these closed formulas, the first term is a sub 1, and for our closed formulas, the first term is a sub 0. Looking at A, we have the sequence 4, 5, 7, 11, 19, 35, and so on. If we're not able to recognize which common sequence it resembles, what we can do is look to see how the terms increase. Notice 4 plus 1 is equal to 5, 5 plus 2 is equal to 7, 7 plus 4 is equal to 11, 11 plus 8 is equal to 19, and so on. So looking at the common sequences below, if we focus on the powers of 2, or the sequence given by a sub n equals 2 to the power of n, notice 1 plus 1 is 2, 2 plus 2 is 4, 4 plus 4 is 8, 8 plus 8 is 16, and so on. This indicates our sequence resembles the powers of 2 given by a sub n equals 2 to the power of n. From here, notice all the terms in our sequence are 3 more than the terms in the sequence given by a sub n equals 2 to the power of n. Notice 1 plus 3 is 4, 2 plus 3 is 5, 4 plus 3 is 7, and so on, which indicates the closed formula for A is A sub n equals 2 to the power of n plus 3. Let's go and just check this quickly. Again, our first term is A sub 0. A to the 0 is 2 to the 0 plus 3. 2 to the 0 is 1. 1 plus 3 is 4. Our second term is A sub 1. A sub 1 is 2 to the 1st plus 3, which is 5. Our third term is a sub 2. A sub 2 is 2 squared plus 3, which is 7, and so on. And now let's move along to B, where the sequence is 0, 3, 8, 15, 24, 35, and so on. This one should be a little bit easier to recognize which sequence it resembles. Notice all the terms in this sequence are 1 less than the sequence involving the square numbers given by a sub n equals n squared. Notice 0 was 1 less than 1, 3 is 1 less than 4, 8 is 1 less than 9, 15 is 1 less than 16, and so on. So we might be thinking the closed formula is going to be a sub n equals n squared minus 1. Let's go ahead and try that, but it's not going to work because for the closed formula a sub n equals n squared, the first term here is a sub 1, and our first term is a sub 0. But again, let's go ahead and try it anyway. Let's assume we think a sub n is equal to n squared minus 1. Well, if we try this, notice a sub 0, our first term, is going to be 0 squared minus 1, which is negative 1, which is not our first term, and therefore the formula doesn't work. And again, it doesn't work because our first term is a sub 0, and for the sequence below, the first term is a sub 1, which means in order for the formula to work, we need to increase n by 1, which means instead of using n squared minus 1, we're going to use the square of n plus 1 minus 1 for the formula. Again, a sub n is equal to the square of n plus 1 and then minus 1. Notice when we use this formula, it does work. A sub 0 is now equal to the square of 0 plus 1 minus 1, which is 1 squared minus 1 or 0. A sub 1 is equal to the square of 1 plus 1 minus 1, which is 2 squared, or 4 minus 1, which is 3, and so on. The formula now works. So we do need to be careful when our first term is a sub 0, and for the sequences below, the first term is a sub 1, which is why it's always important to check to make sure the closed formula works. For C, we have 20, 30, 42, 56, 72, and so on. Analyzing the sequences below, notice how the sequence of products given by a sub n equals n times the quantity n plus 1 does have the terms of 20 and 30 in it, and therefore our sequence does resemble the sequence of products. Once you recognize this, it might be helpful to take a look at the products of our terms. Well, 20 is equal to 4 times 5, 30 is equal to 5 times 6, 42 is equal to 6 times 7, 56 is equal to 7 times 8, and so on. So I think we can probably see the pattern here. Let's see if we can write our closed formula. Remember, our first term is a sub 0, so when n is equal to 0, we need the first factor to be 4 and the second factor to be 5, which means one factor would be n plus 4, and the second factor would be n plus 5. Notice a sub 0 is 4 times 5, which is 20. The second term is a sub 1, which would be 5 times 6, or 30. A sub 2, the third term, would be 6 times 7, or 42. Our formula works. And for the last sequence, we have 0, 3, 7, 12, 18, 25, 35, and so on. So again, this last one's a little bit more challenging. If we focus in on the sequence of counting numbers and the sequence of the triangular numbers, notice 1 times 2 times 1 is 3, 3 times 2 times 2 is 7, 6 times 2 times 3 is 12, 10 times 2 times 4 is 18, and so on. As a result, if we add the formula for the triangular numbers and add 2 times the formula for the counting numbers, we should be able to come up with the formula for the sequence given by D. But again, we need to be careful here because the first term in our sequence is a sub 0, and for the sequences below, the first terms are a sub 1. So let's first try a sub n equals, again, the triangular numbers plus 2 times the counting numbers, which would be the product of n and n plus 1 divided by 2 plus 2 times n. And let's check and see if this works. So a sub 0, our first term, is going to be the product of 0 and 0 plus 1 divided by 2 plus 2 times 0. Well, this actually works out well. This is 0 plus 0, which is 0. A sub 1 is equal to the product of 1 and the sum of 1 and 1 divided by 2 plus 2 times 1, which is equal to 1 plus 2, which is 3. Let's just try one more. A sub 2 is equal to 2 times the sum of 2 and 1 divided by 2 plus 2 times 2, which is going to be 3 plus 4, which is 7. And therefore, our closed formula is correct. I hope you found this helpful.